I was going to do that. So I said that to say, because I'm asking you, like, do you look back and say, okay, damn, I was going to do that. Maybe I should have did
that. I never
had
the big dreams, bro. I can honestly sit here and say that in high school that I had never paved the way to, like, this is what I'm going to be.
Yeah, we were thinking, but what was the dream? Any?
Honestly?
Yeah. Honestly.
Okay, I want to be...
What was the dream?
I want to be a wrestler, man.
High school.
I want the fame. I want to come out with Ravishing Rick Rude music. I want to come out with Ravishing Rick Rude music and be spody and talk shit. And yeah.
So give us a little background on you, starting with grade school.
Grade school, yeah. Grade school, I went to a school on the hill called Henry F. Kite.
Right.
And then if anybody went to school with me from grade school, they know that I'm still that same person, man. How can I say this? I've never been the greatest academic person. I've always just got by. For some reason, it always worked for me. But it's not for everybody. And I just pushed through. That's all I can say about from grade school.
So you saying got by. Can you explain a little bit of that?
Like, okay.
You say you got by. What? In elementary school, what were some of the things that you felt like you got by with?
Okay, we finna get deep with this, right? Yeah. I just lost my cousin Jackie, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
And my cousin Jackie, she had to keep me as a child. My cousin Jackie, she was the life of the show. She was everything, bro. And in grade school, first grade, I've been grown since I've been a child, bro. My mama always had to work, always had to put in her time to do what she had to do. To make a better position for me and my brother and my sister. So therefore, Jackie had to keep me. We just lost Jackie, as I say. Jackie is one of my biggest heroes. One thing about Jackie, she's a party animal. And damn it, at 6 years old, my cousin Jackie let me party with her. Damn it. When she's having fun, Shinard, you go have fun too. Gino, you go have fun too. We all had fun that night when she kept us. We had a party every night. So when I get to school in the morning.
And Gino, can you tell everybody who Gino is for the ones who don't know who Gino is?
Gino was my older brother.
Gino was my older brother. One time for Gino.
Okay. So when Jackie keep us, when she's having a beer, I can have a beer too. You know what I'm saying? Okay. When Jackie's smoking the joint, you know, Jackie blowing, she not hold your nostril like this, and you know, she blowing me a shot. And so when I get to school the next morning, you know, I've been partying all night, bro. Mm-hmm. And I'm in first grade. When I get to school tonight, and I got a book bag full of Star Wars, man, my mama just bought me, and the lady talking about doing some work. Later, I've been partying all night. I got to have a nap.
Okay. So school was a nap.
And what's so crazy, you know, my mama, the teacher explained to my mama, ma'am, he's coming to school just sleeping and doing blah, blah, blah.
Right.
Shoot, my mama come. That's a lie. My son coming to do that. I'm doing everything this teacher said I'm doing. And my cousin Cindy, she been telling on me since I've been a kid, you know. But she'll tell my grandparents, she ain't doing this work. But she meant nothing but good. But I've never been an academic student, bro. Seriously. I've always been that middle child.
The middle child. Okay.
I've always been that child, that problem child, that child that's going to do what he's want to do.
Off rip in middle school. Start middle school. I'm sorry. elementary school. So you say
you remember middle elementary school? How many times? What year you saw me in middle school? Seventh grade.
Yeah.
You know why? Because summer school, I got kicked out for having a gun in school.
Yeah.
Yeah. You didn't see me eighth grade at Paxson. Because my mama had to pay for me to go to private school.
Yeah.
Which I got kicked out of. Man, I went to a place called... Bro, let me tell you about eighth grade.
Okay.
I went to a place called...
We're in middle school now.
We're in middle school. Okay. I went to a place called... It's no bigger than this shop here. I went to a place called Cooper's Academy.
Cooper's Academy.
And it was me and another dude in there. To go to this private school. Yeah, on 45th and Avenue B.
Right.
And that was my eighth grade year. And you know what we did every day?
What?
We watched the game shows and we watched the Young and the Restless. Me and them black women in there. And they gave me a passing grade to go to the ninth grade. And that's how you continue to meet me in high school, brother.
So
Would you say that you were a child that was really blessed, or you were underprivileged?
I don't know what underprivileged is, and you came. Well,
that's what I want to
know. You meet people
and they try to sell themselves out like they, man, we had to come from the dirt, and you had a pool in your backyard. Stop that shit.
Okay, you had a pool in your backyard.
I didn't have no pool in my backyard. Yes, we had a built up pool.
Okay,
but I'm talking about some people. They'll try to make it look like they from the dirt, they from the struggle, right, they from so hard. Right, bro, you had a built-in pool in your backyard. Right, you're not from the dirt. You're not from the struggle.
You weren't from the apartment.
Absolutely not. I hung there. I'm not from there. I hung there. Okay. There's a difference.
Okay.
Between being from there and hanging there.
Right.
Dudes who hang there wanna be from there, man, and you're not from that, bro. Your auntie is a lawyer, is a doctor. Your mom is a principal. Stop the foolishness, bro. We claim the stuff that we're not.
Right.
And we get trapped into that.
Okay.
Building personalities that's not ours, bro.
Okay. So, Shinard, I'm going to go a little further here. Did you actually make it to high school?
Yeah.
Okay,
let's
go a little further. Let's step a little further into high school.
Yeah.
Because
I was an outstanding student in high school.
Okay. When you say elementary school and you say middle school, okay, did you learn anything from going to, what was it you say you went to?
Cooper's Academy. Cooper's Academy was like a daycare.
Right. I'm saying that was basically a punishment for what you getting caught with the gun, right?
Mm-hmm.
But at Paxson, wasn't that normal? That was normal for us to have a gun at Paxson. You know what I mean?
Yeah, like I traded off several arms at Penn.
Right. Yeah.
I traded off several arms at Penn. But you know, you got to understand what I was in middle school with it. And
so before we go further, we want to know your background. When you told us about Jackie, we told us about, okay, we want to know about Samuel.
Mm.
That's what we want to know about right now. We want to know about Samuel. Okay, Samuel came in this world. Samuel, boom, boom, boom. That's what I want to know.
What's your question?
My question is, okay, how did you become, you say you parted with Jackie.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
I haven't stopped.
Did that intrigue
to,
you?
To
like,
this day, I haven't stopped. I'm still Shinard, bro.
Right.
At all times,
mm-hmm.
I'm still Shinard. I know I can't do as I want, but for the most part, I'm gonna make a way to where I don't have to follow the crowd. I don't have to be appeased by what you think. Mm-hmm. I don't have to fit in.
Great.
Damn your crowd. Damn what you got going on. I don't like you no way. Matter of fact, I think it's square.
That's what I want to hear.
Matter of fact, I think it's square. I don't have to fit in, bro. Yeah, and I think y'all kind of funny. I see too many people at this age in life. We almost 50, bro. I just turned 47.
Shinard, I don't want us to get ahead of ourselves. Okay, well, I got to stop. Y'all want to go back.
My feet ain't for nothing.
I got a question.
Well, give it to me.
Oh, Dr. Mitchell or Dr. Threadcraft?
Dr. Mitchell said,
Which one you like? This is a passion question.
Dr. Mitchell said, Dr. Mitchell had a saying, man. It can't come to me. Dr. Mitchell's the real deal.
So Dr. Mitchell?
Yes, Dr. Mitchell's the real deal. Okay. Threadcraft, I ain't gonna get into that because I don't want your podcast to get taken down, bro.
High school, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you was talking about you being Shinard, what did Shinard become in high school? Like, you say you being Shinard. Okay, you Shinard at an elementary.
Mm-hmm.
You was Shinard at middle school. What did Shinard turn to in high school?
The same old Shinard, just doing what he ever would. You was in class with me.
Yeah, I know. I want you to tell.
Okay,
I can validate it.
Okay, you remember when I walk in English class 15 minutes late?
Smelling like weed.
Smelling just like reefer and act like everything is okay.
Yeah.
And sit down, and the teacher, after it became such a repertory thing, the teacher just accepted it. He's not going to get better. He's not going to do it different. Mm-hmm. And that's always been what I push the envelope? I don't know what you call it. But I'm going to do what I do, bro. And especially when I'm not harming nobody. That's where my mindset be messed up at. I ain't messing with nobody, brother. I'm not following the rules. That's where I guess I get it at. I don't follow the rules, bro. Who made the rules?
Right.
What made you come up with this rule?
So any point in your life you feel like that maybe you might have should have followed the rules?
You damn right. Once them correction officers get your ass, and once them judges get your ass, you wish you know that you don't make nothing. You just out here existing. Right. When it get to that level, when it get to that.
How many siblings do you have?
I had an older brother named Gino, and I got a younger sister.
Like you said, you're the middle child.
Yeah.
So how was it like being the middle child?
I did what I wanted. As far as? Everything. I just did. My mama was always work. I don't know nothing about needing, nothing about wanting. I don't know nothing about none of that. My mama always worked and provided.
So was you confused?
What you said again? What you mean?
Like being a middle child. Like,
no.
Was it confusing trying to find your place?
No. It's no confusion when you having a party.
So years? You say you had an older brother. How many years older?
3 years.
3 years.
Yes.
So you never felt like you had to kind of fill his shoes a little bit and be like big bro?
You know what? It's the after years that hit home with Big Bro. To this day, I wonder what Big Bro was on. for him, because we got to understand, I lost my big brother. My big brother was killed at 17 years old.
Right.
What big bro had going on at 17, you don't see grown men have going on right now. Right now, it is what it is.
Rest in peace, Gino, man.
And I still wonder to this day, nigga, what you had going on, bro? Well, I mean, far as with the diamonds and the glasses, with your name in it.
Yeah.
And you're 17.
At 17.
And what hurt me more than anything, what really hurt me, because that's a baby. Right. That's really a baby.
Right.
But the way I see these grown women treat their sons today at 30. Mm-hmm. At 30. Baby, I got your car note.
Yeah.
Baby, I got your insurance. Yeah. I got your rent.
Yeah. At 17, he was doing his thing.
At 7, you a baby.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So it's so now that's what's confusing, and I think you shot a question about confusion. That's what's confusing. Mm-hmm. How we act like this was not a it's a deep subject, brother.
Yeah. So. Would you say that's where your male influence came from? Your big brother?
No, I had a grandfather, and I had a grandfather out this world. I had two grandfathers. My grandfather Shepherd, I got to give him a shout out. My grandfather Shepherd, one thing I salute about him, when you meet a man about business and about I have not heard my granddaddy say 10 words in a row. But when he say something, you know he mean it. He's one of them men. When he said something, hey, granddaddy talking. So that mean he got to mean something. Now, my granddaddy Mayhew, you just don't get no better people. That man told you, I mean, you've met him. You've done business with him. He say, I had 10 years left in prison. That man told me I'm doing better than a minute. And I say, what? I'm doing better than a minute. And he stood on that. You doing better than a minute. Yeah. Now I understand what he mean.
So what did you take from that? What was the understanding?
I didn't.
You saying now, like you said, now you understand what he mean.
Yes.
What was he meaning? What was the meaning?
The conditions of the people when you get out here and you see the people and you see how you telling him what you're doing in life. And you're progressing. And I guess he just got the mind and understanding that, okay, he sound different. Sound like he doing okay. I remember one time, man, my grandfather had dementia when he passed. And I was selling barbecue sauce, you know what I'm saying? And he was down bad with his dementia at this time. And my mama was like, he's doing good right now. I'm finna let you talk to him. That man got on the phone. He said, hey, son, how your sauce doing? And at this time, I'm booming on my sauce. I'm selling both sides. On both sides of the compound, booming.
When he asked me this,
I say, man, I'm thinking in my mind, man, you playing on my mama and grandma, man.
Yeah.
Because you know what time it is.
Yeah. Now he asked me about my sauce. You remember my sauce?
Yeah.
And you don't remember who in front of you?
Yeah.
Come on, man. But it touched my heart so much.
Yeah.
And it let me know that I'm doing all right, man. Because at that point, I knew he was proud of me.
Right.
Yeah. At that point, I knew he was actually proud of me. Regardless of what you're going through, what you're being through, get out of it and keep pushing, bro.
Okay, so you say you were Shinard, right?
Mm-hmm. I was Shinard?
Well, let me rephrase that. You saying in school, you was always Shinard yourself.
Yeah, I'm still Shinard.
So, other than not following the rules, what's your definition of Shinard? Like, break it down.
Be you, man. Be you. Never try to appease. Never try to fit in. I see so many people at this age, and they just not getting cool. They just now getting the crowd letting them come in now, and they doing everything to fit in. Man, fuck them people.
Okay,
that's what I think. Two middle fingers is not just for decoration. They for pointing at people, and I point these fingers at you, man, because I don't need to fit into your crowd. I don't need to fit in with you. I'm me. That's why my passenger seat look like they do. Because my grandfather told me one time, he said, son, how many times have you ever seen somebody in the car with me aside your grandmother?
How many times? That's the question. Shit. How many times?
The silence answer.
Yeah, for sure.
I have never seen nobody.
So okay, after school, right? After school, what? Okay, in school, what would, after school, what would you, did you dream of or did you think about being? Like, you know, everybody say, okay, I'm going to do this, I'm going to do that, I'm going to do. What was your choice of, you know, employment or whatever you wanted to do? Like, you wanted to be a sailor, you wanted to go to the army, you know what I'm saying? Like,
that's a
what was it that?
What was my dream?
Right.
What
right,
was my dream?
Right. What was your dream?
Well, you know I was in the ROTC program.
Yeah, I remember that.
How you remember that? I don't remember that.
I remember your ROTC stance.
I found somebody who remember.
And I'm gonna tell you, I remember Roy Ray. Know what I'm saying? Roy Ray. And that's all I'm gonna say. Roy Ray.
Anyway, yeah. Hey, bro, I had.
So you want to be in the army?
My cousin told me. I said one time, my granddad asked us what we wanted to be, and I told my granddad I want to be on the front line. He's sitting right in here right now.
We gonna get to him in a minute.
I honestly can't even answer that question, bro.
So looking back on it, what would you think? Like, okay, I shoulda. Is it something that when you look back,
shoulda, woulda, coulda?
Like,
shoulda, woulda, coulda. We ain't gonna say.
I had a dream too.
I ain't going off no shoulda, woulda.
My thing was, I wanted to do. When I had a son early, I was like, okay, I'm going to go to the military. You know what I'm saying? But when I found out, it wasn't no money. It was real money. You know what I'm saying? So when I found it wasn't no real money.
You drunk over there. Sit down.
Like, ain't nothing. You know what I'm saying? So that was one of my, okay, I was going to do that. So I said that to say, because I'm asking you, like, do you look back and say, okay, damn, I was going to do that. Maybe I should have did
that. I never had the big dreams, bro. I can honestly sit here and say that in high school that I had never paved the way to, like, this is what I'm going to be.
Yeah, we were thinking, but what was the dream?
Honestly. Okay, I want to be.
What was the dream?
I want to be a wrestler, man.
Hold on.
I want the fame. I want to come out with ravishing Rick Rude music.
You fucked up on that one.
I want to come out with ravishing Rick Rude music and be spody and talk shit. And yeah.
Wrestling number one.
Yeah.
Okay, so, all right. Okay, so.
Whoo. That's funny.
That's funny. So, when we got out, when we was in school, man, we was ready to jump off the porch. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So my thing is, when you jumped off the porch.
Yeah, I jumped right in the back of the police car.
No, I got to say this. And I ain't dry snitching or nothing.
Give it to me.
But y'all niggas was some ruthless niggas. You know what I'm saying?
When you meet real people, you realize, man, y'all just playing. Y'all wasn't on shit.
But what you mean?
When you said
that,
you say y'all was some real ruthless niggas. When you get into a system,
right?
When you get into a system, what I've been through, you really figure out, man, you ain't been through shit, boy.
I'm talking about before you went in the system. Okay. We ain't got to the system yet.
Okay.
We talking about when we was roaming around.
Nigga just
them niggas broke the highway and them niggas broke the highway.
You just playing with other scary dudes.
And I'm going to tell you what scared me one time. So, we playing basketball one time. I ain't going to get into it. But these niggas were walking around with yearbooks, right? Mm-hmm. So, if they want a nigga, they got the nigga picture in the yearbook.
Yeah, see, that was just...
So they'll see the nigga in the yearbook and be like, that's the nigga right there.
That's before social media.
Yeah, right.
That's FaceTime in your ass.
Hey,
yeah.
Be like, hey, that's the nigga right there. You know what I'm saying? Right. So...
Impound your ass.
Man, we up there playing ball one day, man. You know what I'm saying? I ain't gonna get into it too deep, but we playing ball. These niggas come up here with the yearbook. These niggas, about 4 or 5 of these niggas. They with the yearbook. So they a nigga right there. They got a yearbook in their hand. They a nigga right there. You know what I'm saying? So while we playing ball, they sang the nigga name. You know what I'm saying? Let's just say the nigga name was John. John. John.
Like Halloween.
Yeah.
Like we're talking to get you, John.
Damn.
That's how them niggas used to roll. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's how them niggas used to roll.
Dumb shit.
Right.
Dumb shit that's not allowed today.
Definitely.
You go get your shit peeled.
Definitely. So, my thing is, my question to that is, how did that become from
Fitting in. Rolling with the crowd. Dumb shit. I'm finna roll with my homeboy. All that dumb shit until you get put in a situation
that you can't handle.
And then you realize, man, trouble easy to get into, hard to get out of. And your homeboy, let me tell you something, man. When you get into some shit, how can I say this? Out of sight, out of mind.
Mm-hmm.
Long as I'm in front of you, man, you everything. Man, you out of sight, you out of mind. You might can talk about me or bring up the mirror. Well, I remember in my homeboy wouldn't never let this happen. But shit, it's happening. And your homeboy doing what he doing, and you still doing what you doing, and life goes on.
Right.
If it ain't family, and this, I stand on this. If it ain't family, how can I say this? It
shit don't work.
It works. But each one teach one, and we got to get back to the village program to where I can tell your child something.
Mm-hmm. All right. Before we get to that,
okay,
because we get into that, I already know how you feel about that. We're going to get to that. So, okay, once you got out of school, right,
and you got, what you mean get out of school?
No, when you was... Yeah, we were still in school during those days. But let's say Shinard, 18. You know what I'm saying? We'll get past that right there, Shinard, 18. Like, was it any slowing down? What was your reason, since you say that? Why did you feel like, okay, I'm done with school? Everybody had a reason. What was yours?
I thought I was a hustler. I thought hustling.
Was it the JT Money era?
JT
Money. JT Money era.
Damn, Tupac. Tupac, bro.
Yeah. JT Money.
Damn right. Yeah. Man, JT Money, man. JT Money, man. Spoil Rotten.
Yeah.
Right. It is what it is. JT Money. Get that man his flowers,
yeah,
bro.
Yeah.
Tupac,
yeah.
Who?
Yeah, he was out
there. We in the South.
JT Money,
bro,
was out
there. Bro, JT Money is everything.
Yeah.
Dealing with JT Money, peer pressure, listen, and you hanging out for real,
right.
It's all adding up in your life.
Yeah.
And why do I need school?
Yeah.
And I got all this going on.
Yeah.
And you fall victim of it. I don't need school right now.
Yeah. And fuck the old, we ain't paying the old, we ain't doing nothing.
Even though I had a grandfather, but he wasn't in the house. Mm-hmm. I had a working mother, a hardworking mother. But she's dealing with work. So if you don't have a man in the house to really tighten up on your ass, you do as you please, bro. It is what it is.
Okay, big cuz in the house, man. Mr. Mayhew over here, man. We just introducing him in here, man. We're going to ask him a few questions about Shinard in a minute. Well, go ahead, Teddy. You got the floor.
One second. I want to elaborate a little bit on Shinard about, and I want you to expand a little bit about teach one, reach one, and a man not being in the house. I want you to talk about that for 1 minute with the people that's out here and how that affects our black men.
Each one teach one?
Each one teach one.
Okay, we're going to start with that. Each one teach one. I was raised in a village, bro. It is what it is. And I was raised in a village of some solid-ass women. Man, I was raised around some solid women from all my older cousins. I was raised actually in a little village, bro, to where when something was going wrong, they could straighten me.
Right.
They see me doing wrong.
Right.
It's no ifs, ands, and buts about it. They can straighten me.
The lady down the street can straighten you. The lady next door can straighten you.
Can straighten me.
And then your mama straighten you after that.
And I'm, no. You straighten me. You don't have to tell my mama about this.
Okay.
You already straightened me. You go to snitch to my mama too.
You don't want
Then once my mama know about it, my grandpeople got to know about it. Hell. Ma'am, you already straightened me. Cousin Matus, you already straightened me. Now, this way down the street.
Right.
If Cousin Matus can straighten. But she could straighten me, bro.
And it wasn't no problem.
And it wasn't. Nothing could be said about it.
That's what we look
The problem for. Is, why did she have to straighten you? Why did you embarrass us in front of her for her to straighten you?
Now, that's a problem with mama.
You embarrassed her. You cousin made us all. You doing what? Blah, 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 blah. Now I'm just throwing, because she's farther down the street. Right. Not talking about cousin Tampi, cousin Ellen, cousin Cora, what they could do to me right off the rip. So the village got to get back in. Don't touch my son. You know your son is
so that was my next question. So what do you think the difference is between then and now?
Nobody can tell nobody nothing. And you know it's a fuck up. You know it's a problem. And nobody
where the problem lie?
At the parent. The parents want to be friends. My mama was never my friend. My mama was never my friend at all. She was always my mama. I'm mama. You get me wrong, I'm straightening your ass right here. And that goes to not just me. People didn't deal with my mama. It is what it is.
Yeah, I know you wrong.
People didn't deal with my mama, man. People didn't deal with my mama because she kept it too real. However you want to say it. She's not going to play. Wherever it started at, that's where it's going down at. You're not going to hear about it later. Let's talk about it right now.
Like something you were saying, like salt and pepper. Like
salt and pepper. You're right or wrong.
You know what I'm saying? Right or wrong.
If you're growing up, the way I grew up, I see now parents that stop by Chick-fil-A. They'll stop by Burger King. They'll stop by Wendy's. And I'm talking about with two children. Because this child don't like this drink, so they got to get another drink from somewhere else. What the fuck? If you didn't eat liver and rice...
You ain't had nothing to eat.
You didn't... Nah, I just want rice. No. You eat liver, rice, gravy, blah, blah, blah. If you don't eat liver, rice, and gravy, blah, 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 you don't eat. Is this abuse or what? I don't know. I don't have kids to say what it is. But I think it's a better way. Because these kids are so privileged. Now, Master P's son say he owe him. The son say...
That was terrible.
You owe me, daddy. Nigga, fuck you.
Yeah, that was terrible.
I don't owe you nothing.
That was terrible. That was
Probably got your first sex behind me, bro.
Yeah.
Behind your image, what I broke.
Yeah.
But my whole point is the privilege... And everything, bro.
I hate to say it. Nigga was trash.
Man,
but
come on, man.
Nigga fuck with him because...
Come on, because your daddy.
Bro. Nigga was trash,
but that's my whole point. That's my whole point, bro.
Okay, Shinard, I want you to elaborate for 1 minute on how not having a father in the house affected you.
It didn't. I don't know how it affected me because... Things happen because I look at people. We have a mirror system out here.
Mm-hmm.
I look at people who have mothers and fathers in the house, and I look at them in their situation, and they're doing absolutely terrible in life. and that just let me know that I had a powerhouse
right
in the home. I had somebody pushing out for me that always knew what I was capable of. You know what I'm saying? I just never pushed forth the error.
Right. Believe it when you ain't believe.
Yeah, believe when I didn't believe. Believe that. And always work hard for me to do better. When I'm at my lowest, still work hard for me to do better. You know what I'm saying? My mama, man, I did 20 years in prison.
Right.
I don't know what a hard day in prison is. When I get my money slipped every month, I had correction officers give me a hard time, show me, because they looking at my slip and looking at their life.
Mm-hmm.
And they're like, how can an inmate be doing this? Doing it like this because of my mama. I'm saving my money. Everything my mama did for me, I got sense. My granny taught me how to make sauce. I'm going to save my money. I'm going to make sauce and sell sauce. And I'm going to save my money because, damn, I do got a date. And things do go on out in the world. I need money in the world. Mm-hmm. So I'm going to take this money and I'm going to send it to my cousin Cindy. Yeah, they do mail out. So every month, I'm going to send mail outs to my cousin Cindy. Right. And I'm going to have me some money when I get out, damn it. I ain't fit to be that word recidivism that I don't know how to spell. I still don't know how to spell it. But
you know the meaning.
I know the meaning, yeah.
And that's why I'm struggling to even ask that question.
To get to prison?
Yeah.
Okay.
What led you?
As I say, I was raised by a single black woman, and they say they're very emotional. Very, very emotional. Okay. Single black women. I was raised by a single black woman who's very emotional, who's very smart, who's very ongoing, who's very, and I took after all her characteristics. So when you play with me, at any time, it's not going to be tomorrow when you hear about it. It's not going to be next week when you hear about it.
Take care of this right now.
Let's talk about this right now. We got a problem, bro. I don't want to, because I'm scary. I'm extremely scary. So I don't need to be scared around you. And you don't need to be scared around, I'm still a midget. Little short person. They call them short people now.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, me and a short person get into it, and we, like, kind of take care of it. I walk around the corner. If he's, like, say you're in the grocery store, I walk around the corner and go in the other aisle and knock his little big head ass out and steal his ass. I say that to say I don't want to have no problem with nobody and be sneaking around. And let's take care of problem. Whatever, communication is the best key in everything, bro. If you sit back and just talk about it, sit back and talk about what the situation, you'll find out it's petty as hell. And so, we need to be going through this.
Your prison, okay. Did you ever, this something I don't know, that's what I'm asking. Did you ever go to jail, like, before you went to prison? Were you ever, like, in the county? Yeah. I don't ever remember that.
No, I ain't no jailbird, bro.
You ain't never been in the county?
Yeah, I've been in the county possession.
What you went to the county for?
Driving a suspended license. Possession of marijuana.
Two
days time, sir.
Yeah.
Nigga, look at that breakfast, and you be like, man, y'all eat that shit?
Yeah, it ain't been long enough.
And niggas be back. They about to get in the fight over your tree. Here it is.
You got that shank.
I hate shank to
prison
this day.
Eggs and all that shit. Get that.
I could never understand how y'all like this gravy over this biscuit shit, this doughy ass shit.
That's good, man. That's your good. Chef, come on now.
I'm
liked it.
I'm about to throw up.
Oh, yeah, always. 2 days in.
Oh, but I'm talking about, no. Listen to me, bro. My 20 years, I never liked shank.
Yeah.
I never understood it. Coffee cake, I never understood the craze of it.
Yeah.
Boy, it's coffee cake day. So
I don't want to ask the question of why.
Yeah, when we
ain't gonna get
that.
You know what I'm saying?
That's why I ain't
going. But I want to know, what was the feeling?
Oh, okay. We'll get
you know what I'm saying?
He just told you.
Like, once.
I still a midget.
Once.
I got sentenced.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay, let's
go. No, not the sentence. Once you was charged, like, after, you know what I'm saying?
Okay. Well,
after the incident and everything, and you know that, okay, this happened, blah, blah, blah.
I tell you.
Before you put them cuffs on.
Put them bracelets on.
Okay, That's what I want
to
know.
Okay, let's get, we'll get to that. Shit, Beaker called me.
Big and Punky.
Damn, I forgot about Punky.
Yeah, yeah.
When I'm right, no. Beaker called me. Beaker called me after the incident. I had talked to Beaker, and somebody was standing in front of Beaker yard. They, you know, Beaker had a truck back then, and but I'm telling them what just went down at the stove, blah blah blah. You know, I'm so hyped. Yeah. So they looking at me like I'm an alien. Like, really, you need to get from in front of my house.
Right.
Really?
Right.
That's really the look that they yeah. got. Right. You don't yeah. did that. Yeah. You in front of my house. You need to. So I go on to the house. I go to my mama house. And I, you know, I crash. I burn. And I crash out over there. Beaker hit me in the morning and say, hey, boy. You know, we had beepers back then.
Right.
Beaker blowing me up on my beeper. 911. So I call him back, what's up, B? B tell me, hey, boy, you know that boy ain't making last night. So I say, he ain't making well. So he like, boy, that boy let you talk about it. That boy ain't making last night. So I say, shit, I don't care. He pulled out the parking lot with me. He must have ran to somebody else.
Right.
I left it alone, hung up the phone,
right.
went back to sleep. But shit, go back to sleep, nigga. That nigga done told you. You know you just on what you just on did. You better wake up and see what's going on. I think about it more and more. I go and talk to Tracy. I go over to Tracy's house for about an hour. I'm just talking to Tracy. I say, man, let me ride the neighborhood. I ride the neighborhood, and that's when I see Pumpkin.
Mm-hmm.
Pumpkin say, boy, that boy up in the woods dead.
Oh, damn. God, man.
I say, shit, damn. That ain't me.
Yeah.
I saw him leave the parking lot. I saw this. I saw this with my own eyes.
Yeah.
You know you what you did, but man, I saw him drive out of here.
Right.
Shit. I drive through the neighborhood on fire, boy. That's you. That girl on toll on you. boy.
Get out in front of my house.
You realize everything in life when it's on, it's on.
Yeah.
But when I tell you, man, them OGs, my OG who really he looked out for me, bro. It is what it is. He and to this day, he's still that dumb. He's still that OG. He's still that neighborhood OG, bro. It is what it is. I salute him. To this day, I'm talking about far as telling my mama and everything, man. He's still that. Neighborhood, and my mom used to ask about how's y'all leader. I'd be like, what? What? She'd never call him by name. Right, how's y'all leader doing? Our leader. Yeah, but it is what it is.
So, okay. After that, right?
Yeah.
You had to go, and I guess
I turned myself in. Saying,
yeah.
I turned myself into to the neighborhood officer.
Mm-hmm.
Also from out the neighborhood, man. He had stopped by my grandfather. Well, anyway, I turned myself in. Yeah, I turned myself in, man. And because I just knew I had me a good case. I thought I did until I ran against Angela Cora. And she let me know I ain't have shit. And
okay, so Angela Cora.
Yeah.
For the people who don't know who Angela Cora is, who is Angela Cora?
Angela Corey was once your state she was your state prosecutor.
Yeah.
But she was my personal prosecutor, you know,
mm-hmm.
before she got that higher position.
Mm-hmm.
And she did her job with me. When Trayvon Martin when what's his name? The guy who killed Trayvon Martin.
Zimmerman.
George Zimmerman.
Yeah.
When I was in prison, they announced on the loudspeaker that George Zimmerman was found not guilty. And as I'm saying this, I'm listening to the officer's voice when he's pronouncing it and the joy in his voice. Man, I cried like a bitch because I'm sitting here doing 23 years in prison for something I know I shouldn't be here for. And this man is free. for killing a jet, another jet dead, for you apprehending him. So I know that's a whole nother subject.
So take me back to the sentencing. I know this is kind of it's a touchy subject for me to talk about because you my dog. But so is it something that you took, like, okay, I'll take this time, or is something that they was like, this what you got to take?
Nah, bro, with me, sometimes in life, man, then this is what it is. Sometimes you can pay for things you ain't get caught for doing. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you can pay for things, man, fuck what I did. And that kills me. I seen dudes who got 30 years for a sales. Mm-hmm. Talking about they ain't do the sales.
What about the other shit, huh?
What about, man, them people offering you 18 months, bro. Yeah. You talking about you ain't do this? Yeah. That's not your hand? And you got 30 years? Make it make sense. Yeah. So sometimes in life, and we don't want to get biblical with it, you might be paying for things that your ancestors did. Mm-hmm. You can pay for things that seven times down the line that it might be coming up on you that you got to pay for. We don't want to get technical like that. But sometimes you got to eat things that you didn't get caught for. What about the things you didn't get caught for, bro? Mm-hmm. That's where I live.
Mm-hmm. Your sentence, what was your sentence?
23 years.
23 years. So how did you process that? Like,
that was the end of the road. It's no such thing as 23 years. When you get to prison and it's 1999 and they gave you a paper.
And how old was you in 1999? 20?
22. So when they give you a paper that says you get out in 2023, it's 1999. You get out 2023. That date don't make sense. It's not even 2000.
Right.
It's not even 2000.
Right.
Then they got the thing on TV talking about when all the zeros clock in, world coming to an end. So it really don't even matter.
Yeah.
Shit, it don't matter. Shit, all of us finna die. So you going with this concept, now 2000 come in.
And nobody don't die.
Now 2000 come in and everything is rolling. Now you in prison. Now this shit finna get tricky now. Yeah. You in prison. You at Lake Butler.
So now we at you, Mayhew. Okay. Go ahead.
All right.
Your question.
My question was, doing that, when that time hit you,
yeah,
what was the process of you accepting? Because it comes with an acceptance.
Yes.
Because it comes, at first, you want to fight it and be like, no, y'all can't give me all this. But then it's a point where you got to lay down an acceptance and say, okay, this is what I got. And I can't fight it no more. No matter how hard I try to fight it, or how hard I try to buck it, this is what I got. So how did you come to relations with
come
that?
To terms with
come
that.
To terms with that.
When I got transferred to Calhoun and seen what prison really was, because prison can kind of trick you.
Yeah.
Prison can trick you. It's a whole other world in another world, bro.
For Calhoun real? Is in the Panhandle, correct?
It's in the Panhandle.
Right.
Yes. Calhoun County. I can't think of that county, but
so how would you feel like you would?
Give us a little insight. Yeah, people who don't know prison.
Like you said, it could kind of trick you. What you mean, trick? Like explain.
When I went to Lake Butler,
what you felt like you was tricked on?
When I went to Lake Butler. See, the outside world has just aspect of what prison is.
Right.
Yeah.
And Hollywood has its aspect, but that's not what prison is. When I was at Lake Butler is like a
reception center.
Reception center. All sick people go here. You anything wrong with you? I've seen people this big before, tall before. Because they have no leg. All they have is this. They have no bottom side. Man, it's not a nursing home. It's a medical facility.
Yeah. Right.
Okay, so you might be the medical orderly. Mm-hmm. You're an inmate, but you are the medical orderly.
You're the orderly.
Well, damn it, if it's a medical orderly, it got to be a medical nurse. Mm-hmm. This nurse might be your damn girlfriend. Mm-hmm. And it might make you forget, damn it, that, okay, even though she's coming off the street and you eating lovely every day because she's cooking, and I hope I ain't telling too much what's going on in the prison system, but it is what it is. You got you a girlfriend in prison, not no dude. This is not a dude. This woman. Is a girl. This is right. a woman who's right. bringing you something to eat every day. You're living a great life. You forgot that, damn, nigga, you got 20 years.
Yeah.
You got 20 years. You're living a life, but you're still in prison. And after a few years, you'll be like, damn, especially if you get transferred, you sick.
Yeah.
You sick.
It's over for you.
So that's the trickery. You
they're transferred, so you sick.
It's a mind
thing. They don't got caught wind of what's going on. They don't got too deep. Now they got to transfer. They got to separate y'all.
They
got
to separate you.
They got to separate y'all.
Break it up.
They got to break this shit up. You sick.
Break it up.
So they ain't going to take up from a job. They going to send you somewhere.
They going to send them to another camp. They going to send them to the panhandle.
They going to send you to the panhandle somewhere. If they don't kill you.
Yeah.
Because this could be somebody's wife. You could be fucking on somebody's wife. And they playing like that. They, especially the officers. Everybody. In them little country towns.
They
play dirty, bro. They
quote unquote on a square. And they square a whole bunch different. Knight Templar type. You know what I'm saying? So they square a whole bunch
how, different. How did it affect you by going to prison so young? At
22. My granny say if they crazy, you is too. And you better tighten up. Say you going to prison for a long time, bro.
Yeah.
And he ain't say it like that, but he said you going to prison for a long time. Mm-hmm. This was his speech to me. He said, you're going to prison, you're going for a long time. If they crazy, you is too. And I stand on that right now today.
Meaning what? Masculine energy.
I don't know what it meant. I don't know what it meant.
Yeah.
I don't know what it meant, bro.
Whatever it meant, you had to match it.
Whatever it meant,
you had to be there.
I know he told me that and walked out the visiting park, walked out the visiting room in the county jail. He never come to see me in prison.
So, do you think it's a school, right? This kind of crazy to the prison pipeline.
Say it again.
Do you think it's a school to the prison pipeline?
A school to the prison pipeline.
Like basically, it's set to fail. Society is setting you up to fail. Like everything going on is a.
No, I think. You setting yourself up to fail. Society is out here for you to achieve. Society want people to achieve. Society don't want police shooting your ass down. Society don't want you snatching nobody's purses. Society don't want you robbing no bank. Society don't want you to succeed. You want to do that dumb shit. Mm-hmm. You out here with that dumb shit. You out here in front of Wawa.
Sure, I agree and I disagree with that, though.
Why are you in front of Wawa? Why are you in front of Wawa's asking me for a dollar?
Well, that's now. We talking about then.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
To be honest, bro.
Now, you said that. Okay.
I never stood in front of the store and asked for a dollar. That's It was never a hustle. Or now.
That's dead.
It was never a hustle.
A hustle. It just wasn't our hustle. You know what I'm saying? I done been behind. I done got locked up and I was behind a begging ass motherfucker. And when they be counting the money out the motherfucker pocket.
Yeah.
Shit, them motherfuckers had plenty of cash more than me. Came you know what I'm saying?
I guess like, that's just a different hustle that I'm not willing to do.
It's all understood. Hustle, you see what I'm
understood.
Saying? So, but what I'm saying is, like, in that situation with you and all that, like, what was and we were stuck in that era of, I'm gonna just say gangster. You know what I'm saying? Like, without lack of a better term.
Yeah.
Everything we did, we was trying to be gangster. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So
show you that I ain't got to be played with.
Right.
You never asked why?
Right. That's what I'm asking.
Why you want to be a gangster?
Okay. For me, did you feel like once you got to prison that that was the attitude that you had to take.
You was gonna be a gangster in jail?
In prison.
Yeah. I didn't lock my locker.
Once you got your sentence. My mama
broke everything in my locker.
That you needed. You ain't need
everything
that.
In my locker. I'm not locking my locker.
Right.
My mama bought all that. It's blood on that.
If you mess with something my mama bought me.
But I lock my door when I go in the house.
Yeah.
Ain't that some dumb shit?
Yeah.
Ain't that some dumb... When I go in the house, I lock my... But I'm in prison where it's nothing but thieves and robbers and dumb shit who live their life on... And I stood on, and I used to tell my mama, Mama, I sell sauce when I'm not in the dorm. She said, no, stop lying, blah, blah, blah. I said, Mama, I sit my bowl on my bunk, and when I sit 20 sauces in my bunk, in my bowl. Mm-hmm. When I get in the dorm, damn it better be 20 soups on my bunk. If it's not 20, say if it's 18, count time, it probably was just a little mistake or something, but somebody forgot to put 2 soups on my bed. I'm gonna make an announcement about my 2 goddamn suits.
So, okay. How long did it take you to get settled in the penitentiary? You know what I'm saying?
The body is a chameleon, bro.
This is my home.
No. That was never my home.
So you never looked at it like that?
Fuck no. No, that was never my home.
So I said that the wrong way.
No, that's what. A dude told me, you know, because I get hyped over things, and dude told me, Shep, man, one thing about you, you got to all realize, you just passing through. You just passing through. You ain't got no life sentence. You just passing through.
So what made you say, you know what, okay, how you came up with, of course, you got to make your money, right? Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So we going to say that, but so how did you sit and say, you know what? Sauce is how I'm gonna make my money. Did you go through other things first? You know what I'm saying?
You go through whatever the hustle is.
You go through whatever the hustle is, bro.
They took cigarettes out. They took cigarettes out from the department. So if you can get you a pack of cigarettes and you know that a pack of cigarettes can go for $300.
You will need a pack of cigarettes.
I need a pack of cigarettes, man. Matter of fact, how about a case of cigarettes? Yeah, I don't want no pack. Give me a case. And most dudes, like, say if they pull a female from, they want drugs. They want, hey, bring me some dope in. Bring me blah, 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 because they're most addicts. I want some oxtails and rice. Girl, I don't think you can cook. I don't think you can really cook that good. I bet you can't cook no fried chicken. I don't want nothing, even though that can take your job.
Yeah.
But I don't want nothing that's going to just flat out. Your job is gone. I don't need no dope. Yeah. I don't need no heroin. I don't know what to do with this shit when I get it. Yeah. If I get it, I'm stuck with it. So I don't need you to lose your job like that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I want some fried chicken. I want a chicken breast and some red beans and rice. And that's how you start it off with. And then you get, hey, you don't even know a pack of cigarettes costs $100, man. You know you get 50 of them. It is what it is.
So.
Shop every day.
For sure.
Do you have a routine?
For sure.
Do you have a routine?
Every day.
And see my old lady get mad because I tell her I'm still on a schedule.
Yeah.
A chain. If breakfast is not served like at 5 o'clock in the morning, mm-hmm. in the chain gang, every inmate know, boy, it's a problem. Mm-hmm. Bitch, if it's going on 5:45, 6 o'clock, and breakfast ain't served yet, it's a shakedown.
What I want to know, not to cut you off, but okay. Man, you my boy. You know, we go back, but the 20 years, right, was it ever a time in that 20 years where you felt like, I don't know, you know, like, man, like giving up, you know what I mean?
No, I ain't never thought about
like
giving
when
up.
When I say that,
okay.
Let me explain what I mean.
Like, I never thought.
Like, you know how you be out here.
I understand what you're questioning. Uh-huh. I never realized that I was getting out.
Mm.
Until, like, I had 3 years left. That's when I realized, boy, you finna really go home. The rest of the time, I'm just doing time in the chain gang, bro. You become a victim of your environment,
almost a zombie state.
It's not a zombie state, but this is where you've been for 17 years. This is what you see every day. This is what you wake up. This is when you walk. You know when it's tension on the combat. This is what you know. This is what you see every day.
Right.
So to realize, damn. But especially when you're at places where nobody's going home. Somebody might go home one time a year. And it's like a celebration. Then when you go get to work camp, it takes you to get to work camps to realize that it's real. That damn, Joker going home every other day here. Almost can't believe it.
Oh, when you get to work camp, you finna be reintroduced.
So is that's it when true you start- that you have to make a decision? Game, God, punk.
No, them decisions.
Religion.
No, them decisions was already made.
It's not a must that you make those decisions.
Man, I know.
Like, that's what everybody say. Like, it's a must. Man, you got to be a Muslim. You got to, you know what I'm saying? Join this. You got to be in this game.
That's all. If you want to do it,
it's all a myth.
All that's if you want to.
That's all if you want to do it. Nah, man, that's all it is. Nah. That's it. What you got to join out here to be successful? What you got to join? You got to join self and do what's right.
Yeah, right.
You got to join self and do what's right, bro. Bro, you got to join self and do what's right. That's
your life. What kept you strong?
My family. Support system. I had a support system.
Right.
Him and my cousin popped up one time, bro. And I'm going to the visiting park and both of them out there. And by them not planning it, both of them at the visiting park the same day. And for them to wake up with me on their mind.
Wait a minute. Can I speak on it?
Yeah, I want to hear that. Let you speak on it.
Listen, me and my cousin ain't playing this, but we just so happened to pop up at Cross City at the same time.
Mm-hmm.
But we ain't even playing it. I ain't talked to her and tell her I was going, and she ain't talked to me and tell me she was going.
For them to be in the parking lot at the same time.
If we don't show up together, we can't go in to see them. But we showed up at the same time.
At the same time, so, bro.
If you want to talk about divine intervention,
yeah.
Family,
yeah.
Intervention, the people upstairs talking and getting things straight.
Support
but we showed
system.
Up at the same time.
Yeah.
Bro. We showed up at the same time in Cross City.
Which is 2.5 hours away.
Everybody know what Cross City is.
Ooh.
So, ain't no place for us.
Listen to the name
ain't
of
no
it.
Place for us.
Listen to
you
the name of it.
Cross for us to be in. You feel me?
Right. Yeah.
So we just coming there to see him. But we show up at the same time and say, cuz, what you doing here?
Yeah.
You know, I already know what I'm doing here.
Hey, when I walk,
what you doing
when
here?
I walk into the visitor park, I can see the parking lot. And I'm like, damn, why they out there hugging like that? Like they ain't never seen each other. Not knowing that they ain't playing this trip. They just out there hugging and happy.
Yeah.
Shit, cause they man, it is what it is.
It's divine intervention.
And I felt so pretty for them to wake up and think about me like that. Mm-hmm. That's what it was.
So boom. The night before, you finna get out. It's your day.
I said, Minnesota for $2, such, such, such. I say, what? You know who Man is? Man is dude from my picket. Childhood friend. Yeah. My next door neighbor.
Yeah.
He's my neighbor.
Yeah.
Childhood friend.
Yeah.
I can't believe Man got my damn. So I can't believe this shit. Yeah. I can't believe this shit. So I know the white dude ain't for the lounge. So
yeah.
Man sleep. Got the towel over his eyes, sleep.
Yeah, yeah, got the towel over his eyes.
I wait, I say, Man. I tap him on the forehead. Yeah. I say, Man. White dude standing up. I say, dude, say you got my soul. He cracked that. You should have seen him walking out. Yeah. US 19, old boy. Man say, Cuz, I didn't know that was yours. Yeah. So with that statement, Man, I didn't know.
Yeah,
I didn't know what to
two
do.
Days before how you to go react. Home,
two days before I go yeah. home.
So you in a conundrum, man.
Do I prove,
your word is your word.
Do I prove to the dorm that I am him?
I am still who I am.
I am him, and I got to live on my... Or do you take your dumb ass home, oh, nigga? Yeah. Nigga, do you take your dumb ass... And I call Cindy with that shit. And Cindy...
Old Cindy probably gave you a whole mouthful.
Cindy say, nigga...
You don't get that.
Nigga, I'll buy you 100 suits, man. I'm telling her, nah, it's the principle.
Yeah,
nigga, what ain't no principle?
Ain't no principle on them soap. Like, there ain't no principle.
So that's how we messed up in that sense. But we messed up all over the world like this.
Yeah, I say that. Principle be petty sometimes.
Yeah.
A lot of time.
We got grown men out here talking about a flag and a color and a principle of the matter. Mm-hmm. Bro, ain't no principle of the matter when you got... When you got dependents and when you got responsibilities and when you got loved ones who've been supporting you, it ain't all about but you. Mm-hmm. What about the people who've been supporting you? What about the people who've been shooting for you to do right? Who've been bragging for you?
I think the principle of the matter is when you neglect them and put yourself first and say, I'm going to do this regardless of what anybody else says or thinks. I'm going to run with my own emotions and say, the hell with my family, the hell with my kids who I'm looking out for. I'm gonna jeopardize myself, my family, and everything I live for.
And the shit
on
never
this
worked.
One principle that I stand on, and it's real petty.
Yeah.
And we as a people, we gotta stop doing that shit.
That was real. That was real. That was real. That shit.